We had no instruments that could compete with electric instruments. There were no such things as electric marimbas. And so I was able to get tremendous satisfaction from doing some recording with him. But the idea of traveling, of being a member of the band, was something that seemed completely out of reach for so many reasons, and not the least of which was that we didn't have the technology for it. And then one day, he said to me, you know, you could make your marimba electric. And he described to me about Barkus Berry and transducers, and I thought, well, this sounds just wonderful. And then when he said, what they do is they drill into each bar. As soon as he said drill, you know, you'd be drilling into my body, because I owned at that time one marimba, the one that I had had since I was 16 years old. And to drill into that, that was just not going to happen. But Frank was so clever. He said, I'll get my vibraphone done if you get your marimba done. And I thought, you know, if he's going to take a chance with his vibraphone, and I know he'd had that for a very long time, I'll do it. And so we traveled. We were able to travel with those instruments. It was extraordinary. I'll never forget the day that we plugged it in for the first time. I'm technically very challenged. I don't know. I still don't understand really how it worked. And thank God he had he had a lot of people that were good at that stuff. But they got it ready, and Frank handed me a mallet and said, okay. And I just went like that, and it was deafeningly loud. And he looked positively gleeful. He looked almost maniacal. Like, you know, now I can rule the world. I've got all the percussion at my disposal, because Frank was a percussionist. Did you know that? He was a percussionist. And now finally he had mallets that could travel too. So it was an extraordinary thing. And then, of course, he insisted that it would become that it would be made in quadraphonic sound, which in those days was state of the art, you know, inconceivable. So he had me play scales or arpeggios up and down the keyboard, and sure enough, it traveled around you. I've seen him happy on a number of occasions, but that day was special. That was, you know, almost like Dr. Frankenstein in the 1931 James Whale picture. You know, it's alive, it's alive. And it was.